It's Omracer here on the 25th of July 2016. Welcome to see a man engine. I'm not kidding, this has only just been starting to be announced, and I did find out with a project when I was having a meeting on the same day I had to pick up an RMA board on Gigabyte 10 because of that Steambox problem. Anyways, as you see, clouds are reasonably okay. Out in that distance over there is where you will be going, but I am on my way to work as per usual, since now for the rest of this month and August I actually work on Mondays, which means 5 day weeks possibly. So yes, what else? Last week was meant to be my 500th video. I do apologize that it's not gone up because actually I had no idea what I was going to do for it. Deleted the Galaga Legions DX playthrough. These two vlogs for this week make sense. Pokemon Go is doing alright as well. Still on level 7, but I've saw a hell of a new Pokemon like Seal, Machop, and some other Pokemon now, which is improving nicely. But anyway, we better get running to work. This is about 9 o'clock, as you can see, it's on its way to being built. It hasn't been built so far just yet. Oh, nice shot there too. Let's just see a bit more. I've got to get to work. Tunnel right here, so. See, you got.
Please give it up one more time for Magic Martin! Martin!
Shows how big this crowd actually is. Machine is unveiled.
Happy birthday to us. Happy birthday to us. Happy birthday, Cornwall and West Devon Mining Landscape World Heritage Site. Happy birthday to us. That's right. It's 10 years ago, exactly, that they clever and wise and wonderful folk over to UNESCO recognised that the industry and endeavour of the Cornish mining era changed the world forever, and therefore our 3,000 engine houses, our countless miners' cottages, our grand houses and gardens, and our hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of miles of underground workings are now rated alongside the pyramids of Egypt, the Great Wall of China, and the Taj Mahal!
Proper job.
To celebrate this 10th birthday, we thought, out on us build the largest mechanical puppet ever constructed in Britain, and trek it all the way from Tavistock in the east, all the way down to Beaver in the ultimate west. Simple! Hey. Piece of cake. Well, we are here to tell you that we have successfully constructed the largest mechanical puppet ever built in Britain. But we do have a technical hitch. We can't get him to his full transformed height unless he is pushed upwards by the vocal power of 3,281 people. Hang on a minute.
More than that, mate.
Are you in? Yep, okay. My boy Jan's just gone to the wing. When you get back, Jan, we'll have enough. Hold on. So, you have to tell me the Cornish word for tick, which is?
Stem.
Stem. What is it?
Stem.
Say that three times.
Stand.
I'm saying copper or silver, you're saying 10, 10, 10. If I said in pub carrot, I'm asking you, is it in every rock? You say it's in every stone. In pub men. What's it say?
In pub men.
In pub carrot?
In pub men.
Copper, arons.
10, 10, 10.
In pub carrot?
In pub men.
Cover. Arons.
Stand.
And Gwella Stan, best team?
Incarno.
Yes, my darlings, the words are in your little sheet in front of you. One last chance to practice. Hillary, tune up, girl. Pay attention. Convert. Aaron.
Stand.
Input Carrick.
Input Man.
Convert. Aaron.
Stand.
And well, a stand.
Incarno.
I reckon that might just get him up, my darlings. There's one other thing. Let Becky sing the first verse of the lament on her own, and then if you want to join in, you can. There's also a chorus you can join in when we get to the anthem, once the boy's up and good. It's in the little book in front of you. Look over someone's shoulder, or even better, lip read. So, I reckon we've just about ready to start. You ready to start? You ready to start? Oh, look up. There's goings on. Okay, ceremonial hush. Colonel Agamemnon Roger, Ninja was tremendous.
Thank you.
Abel, Pudgy, Quaver, and Pidgeth, and Nurbis, which means our wonderful land, the Cornwall, is but a speck on the face of our planet. Cornwall makes up 0.002% of the landmass of this world, and yet, of all the mineral species ever discovered anywhere in the world, more than 90% can be found right here. This extraordinary geological diversity has driven our history. It has shaped our work, our food, our sport, our music, our philosophy, our language, our identity, and the real people's lives. The real history of real people that run through Cornish mining is what we're remembering today with the Man Engine. Historically, the Man Engine was an extraordinary invention of poles and platforms that you jumped on and jumped off to travel up and down the shaft. Massively dangerous, but saved you the 2-hour climb on long wooden ladders, and so was taken to with alacrity. For many people, the words man engine will always be linked to the terrible events at Levant in 1919, when the entire man engine crashed down the shaft, killing 31 men. So we thought long and hard before using those words, but we decided the words the man engine resonates with endeavor and industry, engineering prowess, triumph and tragedy. And those are the qualities that run all the way through the Cornish mining story. And so, I shall shut up. And we will reveal our man engine. Thank you.
Way. And here we go.
Bye.
After 4,000 years or more of continuous industry endeavour, the stamps are done. The mines are no longer working. Cornish mining seems to have come to an end. And a moment's silence for the thousands of people who have died giving their lives to this industry. Story is not just one of looking backwards and nostalgia. Actually, we can glimpse a light at the end of the tunnel, and we must dig deep into our heritage, because we have to know about our past so that we can understand our present, so that we can create our future.
Stand. Stand. In Cog Man. Stand. In Colonel. Stand. In Cog Man. Stand.
In Cog Man. There we go.
Stand. In Cog Man.
Send our foe out to the Cornish mine.
Stretches back 4 or 5 or more thousand years. And all through the 19th century, waves of Cornish miners came up from Redruth and Cambourne to help you boys out. We don't mind. We love the fact that here on this side of the river, you like to remember your mining heritage. And on a minute, every single building I can see, almost, is built on the blood, sweat, tears, short lives, massive endeavour of the arsenic mines of Wheal Anna Maria that Lord Bedford used to dosh to build this beautiful square. Tabby is a mining town, stannery of the ancient days. And what better place to be the gateway to the Cornwall and West Devon mining landscape world heritage site. That's a snappy little title, isn't it? And therefore, the Man Engine has a gift for you, Tavistock. And I'd like the Mayor of Tavi, Councillor Mandy Ewins, to step 1 inch inside the safety barrier because she hasn't got a safety hat on. Because the big boy has got something for you, mate. What have you got, my lovely? This, my lovelies, is actual offcuts of the genuine Man Engine himself. Made lovingly for you by Mojo, who's driving the van here beneath me. We want you to accept this and to display it proudly and prominently so that the people of Tavistock, West Devon and the Tabor Valley will never forget their important mining heritage.
Yeah. Roller,
where's the...
Yeah, I am doing. Sorry. Thanks, guys.
Thank you very much.
And now, my lovelies, the man engine stands at 12 metres tall!
Woo! 12 metres! That way we'll get.
Thank you very much.
He has been entirely imagined, designed, fabricated, and engineered by a team of extraordinarily talented, dedicated, hardworking superheroes.
Entirely.
We are very, very proud of him, and we're right to set off on a 130-mile journey. We're visiting all 10 of the Cornwall and West Devon World Heritage Monuments. We're visiting all 10 of them, and 20 different events over the next 2 weeks. And if you want a real party, we reckon Geever is going to be the place to be. Saturday, August the 6th. I hope we might see you there. Thank you very much, Travis Scott.
The puppet is now leering down. Well, here we are, lowers himself down as it cools down and hides for the rest of the world until another day to show itself off. And there we go, we've done that. So as the man puppet goes down, we better get heading back that way because I'm technically working and I've got post stuff to post off. And just before this, there was a funny story of me catching a Trattini that was around the place. Hopefully this gets more people this way, that I can sell stuff and make money like everyone else wants to. But that was a very good celebration ceremony of something. Now I am enjoying that, but we're going to get to work. 11:52 and it's just about packing up for its travel to Kit Hill, and I've got some parcels to post off through eBay, and the town is still kind of like busy, so that's definitely a good sign as we walk along and explore some of these fractionless areas where the road is like closing off and driving its way over that way. Ordering our food, 15 for that.
$150
for medium pasty and citrus juice. 10:25, I'm finished for this day. And so, like I said, we've got to go and get this stuff done now. And then I'll be on my way out for that. And then, yeah, I'm going to be heading home because I'm done and I've had a long day. And thanks for joining this vlog on this lovely day, and Om Racer out.